Hey guys, in this video I'll show you how I light the hall demo scene. People had a lot of queries about this demo, which I'm gonna cover in this video. I use 2018.3, which is currently 2018.4 LTS. If you are using a newer version of Unity, then it will be a little bit difficult because of some changes in lighting workflow. Otherwise, you can get the same result in newer version as well. You can see I have used Timeline and Cinemachine to create this camera and light animation. Everything is running real time at 60 FPS. You can see a little bit drop in FPS because I'm also recording at the same time. So let's see how I light this scene, which is pretty simple. First, save this scene as hall tutorial and delete everything except the scene mesh. Okay, so this is how it looks without lighting and any post-processing. I downloaded this scene from Evermotion. I will also give a link in the description for that. This scene basically has two main objects. This one is the main object for the scene, and this one is a shadow caster object, which is used to prevent light leaks from outer environment into the main scene. This hall mesh is set to light map static, which is contribute GI in newer version, and also reflection prop static. This shadow caster object is only set to light map static, and in the cast shadows option, I'm using two-sided option. If you don't want this object to be visible in final render, you can also use shadows only. I have also reduced the scale in light maps because I don't want this object to occupy too much space in my light map because this is not gonna be visible in my final rendering. One more thing that I have already implemented the high definition render pipeline. You can create this HDRP asset by right click, create, rendering, and create this high definition render pipeline asset. Then go to edit, project setting, graphics, and assign this HDRP asset here. Let's also take a look at the materials. This wood material is very basic. This has a diffuse map, and I'm also using a mask map, which I created using Materialize software. If you want to know more about Materialize, please watch my video about Materialize. This wood material is also very basic, just a texture in the base map, and I increased some metallic and smoothness value. This concrete material is also very basic, just a basic albedo and normal map. For all the paintings, I'm using a transparent object with a glass material to catch the reflection, and for the actual painting I'm just using a simple base map. For this painting frame, I'm using a base map with a mask map and normal map, and I'm also using a height map, try to get depth in this detail. And for these objects, I'm using a chrome material, and everything else is very basic, nothing special about the materials. So let's quickly create a camera into the scene. Right click and choose camera. Place the camera in the scene view, then select the camera and press Ctrl, Shift and F to align the camera in the game view. To create the environment, go to right click, rendering and click scene setting. This will create a sky and fog for our scene. Let's turn off this fog for now and keep the sky to procedural. Then go to lighting setting. And yes, I used Enlighten for this scene, even though it's now deprecated in newer Unity version, but I really like the result the Enlighten provides. Even though this Enlighten is slower than Progressive GPU or CPU render, but I will also show you both results from Enlighten and Progressive render. So let's reset this. First, turn off this real-time global illumination and let's switch to Enlighten, even though it's not used anymore. Set the texture size to 10, turn off compress, light map, enable ambient occlusion and final gather, and first clear the baked data. Okay, so this is how it's looking without any lighting. And then generate lighting again. Even though this will take more time than progressive render, but it will give you really nice result. Okay, so now the lighting is baked, even though it's not looking good at all. But if you go to the baked light map, and you can see it has generated a quite nice light map. Yes, I know the quality is very low because I haven't used any production setting, but you can see we are getting nice light fall off and contact shadows. So let's first deal with this unwanted reflection. To fix the reflection, let's create a reflection probe. Right click, light, and create a reflection probe. Go into the top view and place this light probe into the scene. Increase the box size to cover the whole area. Okay, and then click bake all reflection probes. Okay, now it's looking much better. Even though the lighting is very dull, so let's fix the lighting also. Go to scene setting, and in your procedural sky tab, set the exposure to 1. And multiply it to 10. Save the scene and bake lighting one more time. Alright, so now it's looking much better. Go to bake light map and it's now looking much better. We are getting some blue light into our scene. By the way, these settings are not fixed. These settings varies from project to project. Feel free to change them according to your scene. Even though the scene is much better, but still we are not getting a proper skylight feel into the scene. So instead of increasing the skylight, let's add an area light on this opening. To do that, right click, light, and create an area light. Go into the top view and increase the size. And place this just right on top of this opening. For the area light properties, first change the mode to mixed and set the intensity to 500 and range to 20. You can also use this color temperature and set this to a bluish tint to get more skylight into the scene. But for me, this setting worked fine. Let's bake one more time. Alright, now it's looking much better and the lighting is also looking very good. But still there is one problem. If you look at the reflection, you cannot see the flow reflection into the painting. And that's because we are using one big reflection probe the whole scene. So instead of using one reflection probe, let's create multiple reflection probe nearby these paintings to capture the reflection. So to do that, right click, light, and create a reflection probe and place this nearby this painting. Okay, and then increase the box size, select, and let's click on bake. And you can see the reflection in this area is looking much better. This is now and before. Even though it's looking dark here because we haven't added reflection in the whole scene, but if you look into this scene view, you see in this area the reflections are looking much more natural. So let's add multiple reflection probe along the walls to capture the proper reflection. Simply Ctrl D to duplicate, and while placing reflection probes, make sure they overlap each other. And let's try how this looks. To bake all the reflection, choose bake all reflection probe. If you see these kind of splotches everywhere due to reflection probe, you need to create another reflection probe in this area also. Okay, so you see after adding multiple reflection probes, now our reflection are looking much more natural. You can see the floor in the reflection. So let me also show you how this scene will look like with progressive render so that you can compare both the result. And bake lighting one more time with default setting and see how this looks. Okay, so now the rendering is done. It only took 18 seconds. That's why this progressive CPU is very fast. And I think the result are looking pretty much the same. So I think we are pretty much done with lighting. So let's bake this scene with final setting and then we'll move to the post-processing to further improvise the scene. Since I use Enlighten for my project, so this time also I'm continuing with the Enlighten. Change the resolution to 40, size to 2048, raise to 512, and choose a default high resolution preset. And also increase the indirect resolution to 4 and light map padding to 4. So let's bake lighting for the final time and see how this looks. Alright, though final light map is baked and the results are quite nice and the lighting is looking really great. We are getting nice contact shadows and details and we're also getting nice light coming inside the hall. So let's finally add the post-processing. First create an empty game object. I call this post-processing. Then first go to a camera and add a post-process layer. Change the layer to post-processing and also change the layer from here to post-processing. If you don't have this layer, then go to add layer and create a new post-process layer from here. Change the layer to post-process and in the anti-aliasing, choose temporal anti-aliasing. It may look a little bit weird in this scene view, but when you run, it will look fine. Then go to post-processing and add a post-process volume component. Turn on this is global mode and click on new to create a new profile. And then change the layer to post-processing from here as well. Let's first add our favorite ambient occlusion node. Click on all to enable all the option. Set the intensity to 0.5. Let's add a little bit of thickness. So now we are getting nice contact shadows in these areas. Then add bloom to add some glow in our scene. Then let's add color grading. Click all to enable all the option. For the tone mapping, choose ACES. This will add nice drama in our scene. Increase the exposure compensation and also decrease a little bit of contrast. For the lift, choose a dark greenish tone, and in the gamma, use a warmer tone, and in the gain, move the slider to the greenish, something like that. Okay, so we add a nice drama into our scene. Feel free to play with these settings. Then add chromatic aberration. Click all and let's add a little bit of chromatic aberration. And finally add a little bit of vignette in our scene. You can see there's a huge improvement with before and after the color grading. And finally for the sunlight, I used a direction light. Enable the contact shadows. And then increase the shadow resolution to 2048 to get proper shadows. And also increase a little bit of intensity to create the direction light. But you see that this is not looking realistic because we are not getting any kind of bounce light on the ceiling. So to fix that, go to lighting and turn on real-time global illumination and generate lighting one more time. Alright, so you can see after baking the real-time light maps, now I'm getting nice bounce light on this ceiling object. And if I move my direction light, now the global illumination is also affecting. And even if I turn off this direction light, the global illumination is automatically adjusted in the scene. So that's how I light the scene. Later I added a cine machine and camera animation to create the whole demo. And I also used the Unity Recorder to render out the whole animation sequence. If you want to know more about cine machine and Unity Recorder, please watch my video about car rendering demo in which I explained the whole process. Alright, that's pretty much it for this video. If you want to explore this project, you can download it from my Patreon page. Link is given in the description. If you have any queries regarding my videos, you can always ask me in the comment section or join my Discord server. I would also like to thank Hannah Sinkonen, Nicholas Gandhi Korta, and Dimadu for Patreon support. For more videos, please subscribe the channel and share if you like. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.